Hey, welcome, 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 welcome. All right. Raw loves. I'm going to do them live tomorrow. I just did two and they won't upload. I have no idea what that's about. Okay. I am going to do another fast fading. Okay. Listen to me. The last video I did stopped at 39:39. I did, and it said 39:40. Regardless, okay? That's a strong message for you to let go of any situation that's in your life that no longer is serving a positive purpose. Do not cling to the situations out of fear. And I did feel fear there, okay? So it is at the utmost important that you hold a positive viewpoint of yourself and your future. Your thoughts create your experiences. So ask the angels to help you maintain positive outlooks. So I don't know who that particular message is for. But I know it was important for me to mention that again. And I got all these comments. Court, please check once again. The video is the Nine of Swords. Or I said nine and it was the seven or something. It's the Nine of Swords, not Seven of Swords. Listen to me, people. If I said the Seven of Swords, then you're dealing with the Seven of Swords energy. If it's the Nine of Swords, then great. Someone's coming out of anxiety. But the fact that I said Seven of Swords is a message. Okay. I know nobody was trying to correct me or be an ass. Okay. I know you weren't doing that. Okay. So there's that. But if you didn't have a one night stand, then that's not your energy. Good for you. Okay. If you did and that's what you wanted, good for you. You know, it was meant to go down that way. You met a soulmate. In other words, it could have been saying also if, you know, because at the end it was the Nine of Swords. I mean, it was the Queen of Wands, Nine of Cups, and Six of Swords. That could also be saying the person that you just met or you're very attracted to and you wanted to have a one-night stand, whether you did it or not, whoever that resonates with, because that was most definitely the case, that it was a soulmate and that's the way it's meant to go down. Or that saying for the Queen of Wands, you know, possibly hold on. A dream's coming true. You're going to be victorious. But when I talk to spirit and I do my clarifications, whether you had the one night stand or not, or whether you were just H-O-R-N-Y, I don't know the situation. I don't know why I'm not saying that out loud. It's weird. But that was somebody who met a soulmate and is going in a brand new direction. Okay. But you also have that situationship on my board where you have that connection with somebody, and I think that 39:39 message was for them because it talked about fear moving forward. And if it was the Nine of Swords, then this person just has anxiety, which is linked to fear. But I did say the Seven of Swords. Okay. I believe the Seven of Swords came out in one of them. Regardless, it doesn't matter. I think it came out in the third read. They were all linked, ladies and gents. Okay. That's that. I'm going to pull a couple cards. And this is not going to be like an extension, okay? But it was important for me to mention those things. Especially if, you know, once again, I'm going to tell you, if you're in a new direction and the other person you're dealing with is still trying to find themselves, could they come in and you can play part of that help of somebody trying to find themselves? Yeah, but not necessarily. You know, maybe it's just saying this new soulmate is going to step into the picture because the other one is not going to step in. Okay. You can still have a sacred bond and have it not step in, ladies and gents. Please believe that. Okay. Let's just find out what external energy is lingering, please. And these cards are all going to be different. All right. They're not going to be linked together. So we have the Fool. All right. So this is taking a leap of faith. But to me, this can also be somebody who is careless and is just not even paying attention to what's next in their life. You know, because I don't want it linked. This is just, it could be, but this is external energy. Okay. So we will clarify after I pull the external energy to find out whether someone's being foolish or if somebody is, you know, just going for it, whether it works out or not, because it's all about faith and taking a leap of faith. Okay. What else is external to us right now? Ripeness. Okay. So, and to me, that's new moon energy. And that's a new moon. It's also a nine. Okay. So this means, you know, something is here. Whether it's ready or not. That song just came to me. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. I'm gonna find you. And make you want me. See, but that's like, and make you want me. So it's like, that's not good energy if that is like that either. You know what I mean? But to me, it's not necessarily a story. This is external energy. And again, I'm going to clarify and tell you what you're looking at. Okay, so either something's ready or not. Maybe someone's playing hide and seek. Okay. That would tell me someone's playing games. But let's see. Abundance. Okay. Which was reversed. So someone could be very unhappy. We'll clarify. I don't normally read these reversed. But this is also the Eight of Wands. This is also travel. It's also a message. And at the bottom of the deck, we have the blank slate. So let's clarify and see what the external energy is telling us. You know, the Fool, you know, is, I see Aries new moon. You know, I see people taking leaps of faith. I see people, you know, whether people want them to do it or not, going in new directions. You know, it's kind of like a screw you energy. I'm doing it anyway. Tell me about the Fool. But let's find out. See, nope, this person, this is a good Fool. Okay, this is somebody taking a leap of faith. This is also movement. Okay, this is going in a new direction, a new home, new location. Whatever this leap of faith is that someone's going to take is going to end up being solid. Okay, so that's a good thing. So tell me about ripe. It was a three of hats, but I didn't say ripe yet. So tell me about ripeness, please. Four of pence. See, it's not ripe. It's not time for something. Okay, with someone. I don't know if it's premature energy, but this is somebody that's holding on to something that's been dead for a very long time. And you got two fours. You got 44. Overall energy is an eight. Be careful you don't repeat the cycle with whatever's happening right now. Where's my little... So somebody's holding on to something that's, you gotta let go. You're thinking it's time, it's ripe, it's not. Tell me about abundance. Tell me about abundance. Seven of Wands, okay? So it's like bickering, standing your ground, being bombarded, lots of external energy around you, controversy. So it's almost like not really being happy, okay? Or in order for you to be happy, you know, you got to continue to stand your ground. But I think you're battling something. I don't know if it's worth it or not. I didn't want to link these, but I was just going to say, I think you're battling something that you should have let go of a long time ago. But I didn't want to link them. But in all reality, I already linked them when I said 44. So it's like, if you want your happiness and you want to move in a positive direction, you got to stand your ground. You have no choice but to battle external energy. So whoever's around you, you know, just energy in general might be a little bit of a battle. Tell me about the eight of wands. But it's like, it's almost like you know to keep moving forward. Another four. Something's gonna go down. Whatever this is emotional to me. It's like you're pouring the damn cup out. Like, there was an opportunity. Someone might be giving up drinking. But besides that, like, you're pouring the cup out. Like you don't want it. It's like not wanting to deal with emotions. It's like, damn, that can go either way. Tell me about the four of cups. So I don't know. It looks like you might get a message. I don't know if somebody feels like they missed an opportunity. It's the Knight of Pentacles. I don't know where I saw a message, and I just said that you might get a message. What made me say that? Oh, the Eight of Wands. There is a message. You are dealing with the slowest knight in the whole deck, though. You know, this is somebody who it takes a long time to come in. But this type of message is somebody who wants to give time. So I don't know if they feel like they missed out on an opportunity. But like, wow, I don't know why I can't read this Four of Cups. If someone that's normally like bored, or, you know, the opportunity is here, or stubborn, or you feel like you missed an opportunity. But like, to me, it's like, they're not letting me read this Four of Cups. I don't understand what that is. I really don't. So I need you to interpret this card on how you interpret it by looking at it. Because it's like, to me, it's like someone had the opportunity. And it's like someone sitting. I don't necessarily know if it's arrogant. But it's like the cloud is getting dark. It's like the shit storm. Before, like, the chaos before the storm. I don't know how to take this. You got three cups up, you know, and it's like you're just focused on, I don't know. It's like, I can't tell if this is emotional for you. I don't think it is. I think it's more like somebody not wanting to share their emotions. So very strange. However this resonates for you, because this is, they're blocking me from this meaning, and I don't know why. and being blocked from it. But I do know you got a message coming. You got two messages. The blocking me from that, I don't know why. What the heck? Hold on. Yeah, I'm not even going to look into it. I'm being blocked from the meaning of that cup right now. I don't know what that's all about. All I know is that you got 444 on the board. I do know that somebody's been holding on to something that is over and done with. It's dead. Let go, whatever this is. Let's clarify the four of pents, please. I don't know if it's just premature energy. You think it's timing, but it's not. But you do have a blank slate here. It's like you start with the Fool, a new start, and you end with, you know, a new blank slate. So it's like, that's beautiful. Queen of Swords. So it's like having compassion, the hand is out, okay? But not tolerating no bullshit. But there's been a lot of growth here with someone. But somebody cut out. What this is telling me is that the Queen of Swords finally cut something out. Finally said, I'm done holding on to something that's dead. I'm tired of thinking it's time. But they still have compassion, and there's growth. So this, she's now being more logical than anything. It looks like she cut something out of her life, which is good. It's got to be good because there was no freaking reason to hold on to whatever this was that you were holding on to anyway. It was dead. You see what I'm saying? So, like, that's a good thing. I don't know if you guys want to look at it like that, but to me, that's a good thing. That's a proud moment right there. That's responsibility. That's leading with your mind versus your heart. And sometimes that's necessary. But if you ask me, you're using your heart too because you got that compassion. You know what I mean? Tell me the lesson for this Queen of Swords here, this pile. And I will tell you, all those add up to 13, which is a 4. So that whole pile right now is a 4, and that's a 4. And that's a 4. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, that's a 3, actually. Regret, I know that I can't change the past, all right? So it's like, see what I'm saying? This person cannot change the past. She might regret letting go of something, but she also knows she had to, so that's not a bad thing. I don't think she's sitting in regret, to be honest with you. I think she knows she can't change the past. She finally let go of something. She might feel bad for having to let go of a certain situation. Yeah, see, it looks like she had to let go of the King of Pents, but she can be victorious, okay? So, or it's this person that has regret. I don't know. I'm looking at it as the Queen of Cups, you know, knowing that she can't change the past. She's moving forward. She's going towards abundance if it's all linked. But she does going to have to stand her ground. I'm telling you, this politic, there's some, this is straight up controversy to me. But she's going on her path, guys. It's a 7, okay? So she's taking that leap of faith, relocating, going towards a solid foundation. She had to cut something out. All right. So yeah, it's like balancing out the scales, going to our happiness, it's reciprocity, duality. It's even linked to work, foreign countries, exchanging money. I don't know where the controversy is. I don't know. It could be charity work. It could be a majority. I don't know. Let's just clarify this Knight of Pentacles because there's no point in me digging into the Four of Cups because it's not the purposely blocking me from that. I don't know why. We have the Strength card and it was reversed, okay? So it's like, but I'm not reading them reversed. So this is having strength, a message, you know. I think this message is external to you because you let go of something, whether it still sits and lingers. Moving forward, I don't know what it is. But it's the right decision for you. Clear as day, it looks like it's the right decision for you. And it's having strength for whatever message this is. They want you to have strength. I don't know. It's ironic because they're not letting me read this card. But what and it's two messengers. So whatever message you're about to get, ladies and gents, it's going to require strength. And damn, at the bottom of the deck is a tower. See, I don't know, guys. I'm not going to sit with it because I won't figure it out. They're not going to let me figure this one out. So I'm purposely being blocked from it because they want you to know. This is like one of those figure it out, you know, like don't sit with it, but like you're gonna, it's I want to be like, oh, it's a missed opportunity, someone feels like it's a missed opportunity, you know, but it's like, if someone feels like if it's a missed opportunity, they're not going to reach out. So it's not, that's not what it's saying. So I don't know, ladies and gents, I'm going to stop talking about it because I can't read into it. All I know is that they got the tower at the bottom. Whatever this message is a tower. It's also an awakening. It's like an enlightenment, you know? And it looks like it's going to come from the King of Swords and the Wheel of Fortunes here. You know, Knight of Wands, fast energy coming in. Thinking about taking a journey with you. Thinking. So, I'm a love channel, so I'm going to clarify each pile with a love card for you. Tell me about the Fool and the Four. The Fool and the Four of Wands, please. That's even like a marriage. That can be a honeymoon. That can be just so random. But to me, that's a move. I just pulled wedding, okay? But here's the deal. You guys have known me long enough to know that this wedding card to me is never a wedding. It's only happened once. So to me, someone did something foolish. And they probably left the house. See how quick those dynamics just changed? I'm telling you, now I gotta clarify wedding. Because that wedding card to me, nope, never, never, never. Is that a good thing? So that means someone did something foolish. Someone did, you know. It's the world reversed. So whatever happened that foolish was never finished. It's a strong Saturn lesson, Sagittarian lesson. It's coming back around. Because the door was never closed. So this is someone's karma coming back around. And something was just not hashed out. Clear as day. And you got the King of Swords at the bottom of the deck and it's reversed. So you could be dealing with an Aquarian because you got two Aquarians right there. Fixed sign. It doesn't matter though. This person's not talking to you. Okay. So I don't know if it's the Aquarian energy that know they did something foolish. I shouldn't have changed the freaking dynamics like this. It's going to get flipped because karma's coming back around. So you're going to have a conversation with an Aquarian or somebody who's carrying the Aquarian energy, air-like energy, logical. Okay. I don't know. There had to have been some type of deception. I don't know if they were foolish there or not. Because underneath that is the Knight of Coin. And you got the Knight of Coin here. So it's linked. Tell me about ripeness, Queen of Swords, Four of Pentacles. Okay, engagement and a safe view to love. So this is something that, if it comes together, it's going to escalate really quick. But I think it's the Queen that no longer feels like she's in a predicament where she feels safe, where she feels she can trust this person, where she feels like she's going to get that type of love that she's looking for. But this is also telling me if you choose to come together, this is something that's going to escalate quick. Okay. So it looks like there was some deception with whomever's coming back around. Because that's karma coming full circle. And you might just cut it out. But if you do cut it out, I'm telling you, it's because you feel like it's not safe, you know. Which I don't blame you, because that is not a good card for me. Tell me about it's safe for you to love. But again, like, that's you. It's the Palace of Swords. All the palaces are good, too. All right? So it's whatever this is. You're going to use your mind versus your soul. But that's a good, Palace of Swords is a good one. It talks about two people, and it is looking right over at the King. It's like this person's like going to intercept. It's not the prince or the page. It's not someone watching you guys. It's two people in a happy place, okay? You do have the Ace of Swords here. So, again, that's going to flip and a conversation's going to come in. And Temperance was right there. And you actually had those two side by side. Tell me about Abundance, Six of Pence. Back in the Seven of Wands. If you stay on your ground, stay in your belief, that could be a gift from the universe, too. All right, but this is healing family issues and religious factors. So this religious factors, where'd that just go? This religious factors is cultural, religious, spiritual. It's either spirituality is bringing you together, pulling you apart, different beliefs, but it's like healing and forgiveness is necessary here. And with the wedding card out, forgiveness would definitely be key. So, and like I said, it's controversy. See what I'm saying? So that links, that makes a lot of sense. But it's also healing a situation, which would be that. As of right now, it looks like you guys will have a conversation. Whether or not, you know, because right now you're not talking. It was reversed, but it's this person's karma. It's the King of Swords karma to come back around and have a conversation. By then, I don't know where she'll be. You know, I'm not sure. So tell me about... That's a whole lot. I'm going to re-pull. But the message over here in Having Strength, and it says, express your love, you know, in new love. But let's see. Eight of Wands, Page of Pentacles. Eight of Wands, King... Knight of Pentacles, Eight of Wands, Knight of Pentacles. Chemistry and codependency. There's something here. There's some type of addiction. There's some type of something. It's this person's having a hard time delivering a message. They are sexually attracted to you. There's no question. Because under all this, the Temperance and that, I did see that with the Six of Cups. Okay, but like regardless of that, like I did say... That might be some type of addiction. They're not going to let me dig into it. But if you ask me, that codependency, somebody could be stopping drinking. And I'm almost positive I said that. Because that could be stopping. Because I said that's the slowest night. That could be stopping whatever this is. But they're not going to let me dig on that. Nor do I want to. But if you ask me, somebody's putting the cup down. Two of Swords, so they're deciding, trying to decide, and they're at the Ten of Swords, so it's like, whoever's energy this is at the wit's end, so when you get this message, I don't know if he or she, if this is a he or a she, it is a she and there's a he, but like, someone's at the wit's end. But again, it's, you know, trying to make a decision. The decision wasn't made. But it looks like someone's trying to stop drinking. Whole lot of information. I'm going to pull you one overall message. It does look like if you choose to have a conversation, because it's definitely coming, this conversation's coming, because that's going to come back around. Yeah, look at, see, that conversation is the Four of Fire. Contentment, peace, abundance, happy home life, successful completion of a project. That can be a project. That's the home life. That's the abundance. That's a message. I don't know if you ask me, whatever this is, all these fours too, it talks about a very solid foundation. With or without, I don't know what you're going to do. But that's your message, and that's someone's outcome. With or without. There's that awakening with the tower. It's just a temporary standstill. It's important to be yourself. The Emperor with the Four. High Priestess. It's a whole lot of energy. I love you guys. Hope this helped. I don't know why I felt the need to do this again. And it wasn't even necessarily about the sevens and the nines. It's like, no. Give me a break. I don't know why. I didn't take offense to that, guys. But I'm telling you, there's something about, I don't know. If I was saying seven after seven after seven, guys, it talks about getting on your path. That's the point. If I'm saying seven, it's a seven. Okay. Even though it was a nine, but I didn't meet it as a nine. Okay. But this today, all damn day, here's your damn seven. Okay. So I don't want to hear no shit. I know how to read my cards. Don't give me shit. Don't you give me shit. Okay. I love you guys. You do have feisty energy. And again, I don't know why I was called back to do this for you guys. But I was. Okay. So I keep getting my nails stuck. So again, it's like I feel like somebody made a foolish decision here. Like I said, especially with this card, because this card to me was just like, you know, not paying attention. So I don't know what that was all about. But I think somebody was like over and over thought it was right. You know, this feminine energy finally let go. She was holding on to something that was dead anyway. She's going after her abundance. And scales will be balanced. Whatever she's dealing with is political, controversial, something like that. Okay. Again, this can be an addiction. I'm not positive. You are going to get a message and it is going to require strength. You did have the tower. When it's all said and done, you did have the Four of Wands, okay, and you do have a blank slate. This person that was over here, no matter who it is to you, is most definitely coming back. It's karma. It doesn't mean, you know, it's you guys are supposed to be back together, but this person is most definitely coming back, okay? It looks like they're ready to take a leap of faith. I don't know if you are, but I will tell you that karma is going to get flipped and it's going to come back. So I will pull you an outcome card for that first pile because I'm sure you all want to know what that's all about. So I'm going to pull a likely outcome. A likely outcome. Okay. A likely outcome for the wedding card, which is deception, the Fool, and the Four of Wands. A likely outcome. Okay. Okay. Life experiences. A significant life event. A powerful revolution. Revelation that leads to change. It's time to spread your wings and go. Again, it's a seven. Okay. So it's all about finding your purpose. Again, it can go either way. They're not giving you a definitive answer. But it is, like I said, it's a huge Sagittarian lesson. Okay. For damn sure. For damn sure. Check and see where your seventh house is. What's laying in your second house, all right? But I'm not going to dig into that. It's just saying it's going to be life-altering. Whatever you choose is life-altering. And your last message was the Four of Wands, so I guess it really depends on where the two of you are at. If there's enough love to hold it together. It really just depends. All right, guys, I'll talk to you later. Have a good rest of your day. I gotta figure out how to hang you up now. Bye, guys.